Hey, have you ever heard of the book 1984? Well, if not familiar with the novel, it follows the character Winston Smith, who wrestles with oppression living in a society where the political party scrutinizes human activities by the all-watching Big Brother. Now, between you and me, I seriously never read the book. I more spark noted it, as at the time of being a defiant teenager, I found that my time was rather spent playing Halo than catching up on required reading. But in recent years, I've found that the theme of the book has become more fact than fiction. For instance, did you know that China's setting up a mass surveillance system that is going to track not one, but all of its 1.4 billion citizens? From using facial recognition to name and shame jaywalkers, to forcing people to download apps that give them access to all of the photos in their smartphones, so be careful with your nudes out there. It really seems like George Orwell's book 1984 is more real than we ever thought it could be. Hey, my name is Ryan, and if you guys like hearing the news, keeping up on what's current, but you don't want to be so serious about it, make sure you hit that subscribe button and notification bell. Now, in the year 2020, not only is Kanye West probably going to run for president, but China's social credit score, as it's called, is going to be in full swing, and that's a good name for it. It's part of a broad effort for China to build a so-called reputation system that will measure, in theory, the credibility of everyone under China's smog-filled skies. Yeah, and honestly, if you didn't think that your every movement being watched, recorded, and stored for future scrutiny isn't creepy, think about it this way. It's basically Amazon's consumer tracking with an Orwellian political twist. It's creative. But I kind of want to know what you guys think. Do you believe you could live under a credit score system where your every move is being tracked and recorded and used to grade you, basically? Or do you think that it's a bit intrusive for your taste? Leave a comment down below. Now, the Chinese government says that the new system will boost trust and develop a culture of sincerity because fear is a great motivator. And if this sounds like the Chinese government just stole the plot of an episode of Black Mirror, it's because they did. However, I think it'll do us justice if you let me explain how this is gonna work. A handful of private data companies are helping the government develop the system. One such company is called the Sesame Credit. Great name. And they're going to assign citizens a point system between the numbers 350 and 950 points. They're gonna determine what your points are based on things you buy, the people you associate with, and the things you post on social media. For example, sharing a post praising the Chinese government would probably be recorded as having positive energy. And if you have anything negative to say, just don't say it. Because low scores will receive punishment. And citizens have already suffered for punishment, such as Liu Hu, who discovered he was banned from flying because his name was on a list of untrustworthy people. Other potential punishments for low-scoring citizens could include slower internet speeds, restricted access to businesses, and being prohibited from entering certain professions. Not controlling at all. But the interesting thing to me is that people are signing up for this in droves. Why? It's possible and likely that citizens are signing up in fear of reprisal if they don't. And then there is the incentives. For instance, a high social credit score can be seen as a symbol of status, and it can earn you more prominent visibility on dating sites. So boys and girls, get your Tinder apps ready and get hitting it. Not only that, but there'll be perks, you know, such as business gift cards, maybe to Olive Garden, faster check-ins to hotels and airports, and no required deposits on rental cars. Sweet deals. But here's the thing we really need to understand. What I think China is doing here is selectively breeding its citizens to choose traits that go against critical and independent thinking. Now, this may not be the purpose. I hope that this is not the intended purpose. Nevertheless, giving only the obedient people the ability to succeed and pushing down the people that have any critical thought of what is going on in society, how does that further humanity? That's the thought I want to leave to you. Remember, I'm Ryan, and I'll be seeing you guys in the next video.